perhaps in Asia. So give a clap for yourself. I'm still waiting for the pen drive. I cannot connect to the internet. I have no idea. Maybe allow me to do a brief introduction about myself. So I'm actually representing Google to conduct the Google Ignite program for Sunway University. I'm also the senior trainer for Glip Academy Asia. So it's actually a company that aspire to develop professional in digital marketing and e-commerce and other knowledge or skill. I'm also the head of e-commerce of Royce Lango. So I actually have to sell my company products to many countries, more than 90 countries worldwide, selling wine and bar accessories, selling home decor item, and selling children's gift using e-commerce website and marketplaces. So I hope that you allow me to help you to pass this exam. Besides all this, you know, becoming the senior trainer, becoming head of e-commerce in Royce Lango, one of the most famous companies in Malaysia, I'm also a conference speaker. I just came back from China as the conference speaker for lifestyle e-commerce, and I was also the panelist for web analytics. So the trip was fully sponsored. So if you want to, you know, be the conference speaker, be the digital marketing manager, please, please attend this training and sit for the exam. Plan a good future for yourself. Thank you. So, I cannot show you the slide yet, but I need you to go to this URL to download the presentation slide. So it's HTTPS. So I'm not sure whether you can see. So everyone can access to the slide and download the slide. So you are looking at the slide right now, right? Okay. Oh, cannot access. https://goo.gl. So sorry, can write. Okay, great. So I understand that most of you won't have any fundamental knowledge in digital marketing. So my slide won't be all about theories. I have prepared the scenario questions for you guys, and the scenario questions are pretty similar to the exam questions. Yeah, so don't worry, we will go through the slides. So let's look at the... I'm looking at the slide for. Has everyone signed up? If no, please go to this URL. Make sure to affiliate your account to Google Ignite. If not, your records will not be part under Google Ignite. Then you will lose your internship opportunity. Yes. Yeah. So when you log into the Google Partner, right, you look at the left or you look at the company, then you just select Google Ignite. So you can also download the AdWords Fundamental PDF from here. So I'll show you some of the steps. For example, this one, sign up for a Google Partner account. So follow the step and remember this part is very important. Find your company, affiliate your account to the company name Ignite Malaysia 2015. And how to take an exam. So once you log into Google Partners, right, you look at the left panel, you will see certification, then you click AdWords. But you go, don't click now, just want to show you, you know, what you will be seeing during the exam day. And here, you will see the details, then you can click the button here to take the exam. So, you will have 100 questions, 120 minutes. You need to score at least 80%, so you need to get 80 questions right in order to pass the fundamental exams. So today we will cover... Okay, so what if you fail the exam? Don't worry, after 7 days you can retake the exam. And this Wednesday, if you take the exam, your name will appear here. Fundamental certificate. Yeah, and of course the internship opportunity for one of the famous company in Malaysia, for example, P&G, Nestle, it's a great start for your career. Okay, what we will cover today? So, we have 4 topics here. We are going to learn about AdWords and we are going to understand the ad format, how AdWords ads look like, on search ads and display ads. And we will understand how Google determines the positions, ad positions, and then we learn how to set up the account. And of course, we need to know how much should we bid. How much should we pay to Google? How can we compete to other advertisers? So for tomorrow topics, part 2, we will cover the keyword match types, ad text, AdWords tool, how to use the feature provided by Google, and of course Google Display Network, one of the most powerful advertising network in the world. And then we will measure result and optimizing campaign, because when you join the companies, you have to perform, you have to give result for your companies. So what is AdWords? Before internet was introduced, so how the advertiser, how the companies were looking for customers? So they have to use the offline way. Offline ways means that you have to run the TV ads, you have to, yes, newspaper in hard copy, yes, poster, brochure, flyer, yes, and also radio ads. So after internet was introduced, then many of us, we have switched from watching TV to going to search engine to get our information, internet, to get the information, to learn, to understand, and we spend less time listening to radio, reading the newspaper. So what we do now, we focus very much on search engine, website, and mobile devices. So for companies in the past, traditional advertising, if I'm using a traditional advertising method to reach the customers, I have to use a TV ads. I cannot decide my customers. I do not know when they are ready to buy. I do not know when they will buy. I do not know whether they are interested to buy my product. But if you are using internet, especially the advertising with Google, then you have customers looking for you rather than you are looking for customers, because customers nowadays, they get all the information from search engine. They search for products, they search for services, and then they also use the mobile devices to get the information. So the difference here is you have customers looking for you rather than you look for the customers. And another very big difference compared to the traditional advertising and also the online advertising is the budget. Let's say if you want to run the LRT ads, for example, a key stations, not more than 3 stations in Malaysia for 1 year, it will cost any advertiser around 500,000. But if you use the online ads, especially Google ads, advertiser can just spend 36,500 if you only want to spend 100 per day. So for online advertiser, they have the advantage to set the budget. You do not need to spend so much. Everyone can afford to run the advertising campaign with Google. So other benefits, first, advertisers are in control. You will not have anyone reject you because you don't have budget. And you can control the cost. You can spend 100 today and increase your budget to 1,000 tomorrow. And you can decide where your ads want to appear. For example, I only want to target people who use the keyword buy smartphone. I don't want to target anyone else because they are not interested to buy my product. I want to well spend my budget. I want to utilize my budget. And then I can target people who use mobile app or mobile web to read the information. It's all under my control. And I can edit my ads and keywords anytime. Not like the offline marketing where you have to rely on agency to help you to make the changes to the visual and the copy, and it normally will take a few months or even 6 months to complete a project. And here, very important thing offered by online advertising to measure the profitability. In online world, unlike the offline world where you have no idea who see your TV ads and make the purchase, online you can track everything. You can track how visitors navigate your site, for example, whether they have signed up, they register an account, or they make a purchase, or they read certain pages. All can be tracked and can be measured from the moment they reach your website. So now we are looking at Google advertising. So Google advertising consists of two parts. One is the search partner, another one is the Google Display Network. So let's look at the search partners here. Search partner, remember, it only refers to one thing, search engines. Google search engine, whether it's www.google.com.my or www.co.uk. So another one of search partners would be the search partner networks. So search partner networks, if you look at Google Groups, Google Map, or Google product search, they also belong to search partner. But most important one would be the non-Google website. For example, some of the website like AOL, and they don't use their own search engine. If you go to www.aol.com, you try to perform some searches, you will see that they are actually using Google engine. They are actually using search engine powered by Google, enhanced by Google. Because some of the company, they don't have the talent to build a search engine as good as Google, so they just tap on it, use the Google one. And another side of the online advertising provided by Google will be the Google Display Network. Google Display Network is one of the most powerful networks in the world. So let me give you an example. So if today you own a website, if you want to monetize your website, you want to earn money, then you will join Google Display Network. So Google Display Network owns millions of websites. Then, if you join Google Display Network, you must reserve some of the advertising space for Google advertiser. So you have the website, and Google going to put some of the ads on your website, and then you can earn money from there. So that one, we call them publishers. But what if you are the advertiser, you want to spend money, you want to display your ads, you want to run your ads, you want to get more customers. So what will you do? You going to pay Google, use the Google AdWords tool to get more customers. So Google will decide which place your ads should appear. And then Google will charge you what you pay for Google. Google will pay to the publishers. So two parts, remember, search partner and Google Display Network. So, when we talk about search network, where do your ads appear? So if you go to the search engine page, you look at the top of the search engine and the right of the search engine. So it starts from 1, 2, 3, Then continue with the right hand side, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's how Google ranked the paid ads. So what you see here are not belong to paid ad. Any website appear here, they do not need to pay because that is belong to search result. But today, if you are an advertiser, you want to pay to get more customers, then you have to compete for the limited positions available here. And bear in mind that Google search engine, Google paid ads, right, they are actually an auction based. So you have to bid a certain price to appear here or even bid for higher position. So let's look at display network, how display network look like. Let's say today as an advertiser, you want to advertise on display network. So there are four different types of ads available. One is the text ads. So what you see previously, all the words there with header, description line, you also can display on Google Display. So besides text ads, Google Display also allow you to run image ads, where you put your product pictures, where you put the promotion pictures online. And this is the publisher website, then they will reserve one column, one advertising space for you to display the ads. And then beside that, you also can use rich media ads, for example, video ads. So there are different types of ads you can utilize. And of course, the last one is the most popular one, that would be the ads on the mobile website. It's not just targeting desktop, tablets, but you also target the mobile website. So text ads, how text ads looks like on Google Display Network. I want to show you this because unlike image ads where you display only one image ad based on the different sizes selected, text ads, you can display a few text ads here. So that's just an example of how text ads look like on Google Display Network. So just now we talked about image ads, so there are many sizes available here. We have the leaderboard, we have the skyscraper, and we have the medium rectangle. Based on the research conducted by Google, the most effective sizes are large rectangle, medium rectangle, and of course leaderboard. So most of the advertisers, they spend money, they run many years of Google ads and found out that these three are the most popular, most effective ads. Okay, so every business, when they spend money, they want to achieve a goal, a business goal. So it depends on what the business are looking for. It's very important for us to understand the business decisions journey funnel, from awareness, interest, considerations to sales. It depends on what we want to achieve. For example, if the company, they just want to generate awareness. For example, my company, we want to enter a new country, and we want to sell to people from the United States. So when people in the United States, they are not familiar with my brand, what I need to do? I need to generate the awareness. I need to make them aware of by my brand name so that they can come to my website and look for more information. And what if I'm running an ads in Malaysia? I have everyone knowing my brand. So what I expect from the ads will be to get the conversion. I hope people can purchase because they already know my company, they know my product. So now I just want to run an ads to get the purchase. So what we call these ads? First thing, brand awareness. Any ads we want to just generate awareness, we call it a brand awareness ad. And another ads we want to get the actions from the customers, we call it a direct response ads. So if today your company want to create the awareness, then you have to use the display advertising, because display advertising will help you reach a broader group, and most of them would probably browsing other site, for example, news site, magazine, online magazine site, or a mother care site. But you can push your ads there and let them aware of your brand. So when you are running a brand awareness campaign, you don't expect immediate return, for example, sales conversion, because it takes a few steps to reach there. Once you generate awareness, you must make sure that your customers are interested to find out more about your product. and then they need to consider, they need to compare prices, they need to see whether you sell cheaper or you sell more expensive compared to other seller, then they only can decide whether they should buy from you. So remember, brand awareness is about generating awareness, and when you use the display advertising to push your ads, you are not expecting them to take the sales action. But for anyone who wants to run the direct response campaign, they will be using the search advertising. Why? For example, if today I type the keyword buy Samsung smartphone, I'm actually have decided which brand I will go for. So I have gone through the awareness stage and interest stage. I'm at this stage considerations. So I just want to key in buy Samsung handphone and find out which seller will be selling cheaper to me. So at the consideration stage, if I run the search advertising campaign, I will convert them with higher chances compared to the customer at the awareness stage. So basically, these are the different objectives provided by different type of advertising campaigns. So once you have decided your business goal, then it depends on what you want to get from your customer. So I'll show you an example. It's very important for us to have the performance indicator, key performance indicator. For example, you want to purchase. So what is the key performance indicator? Most of the advertisers, they will start with the simplest step first. First thing, I run a campaign, I want to increase site traffic. So how you measure the site traffic? So maybe before the campaign, every day you will get 50 people to visit your site. So after the campaign, I hope that the number of clicks will be increased from 50 clicks to 150 clicks. So that is how you measure the performance. Another important metric here, click-through rate, is also used to measure the increase in traffic. For example, if I have someone seeing my ads, so how many of them will click my ads and come to my site? So this is how we get the click-through rate. We use the number of clicks divided by number of impressions. And then we also can focus on keywords and search term. Because when you want to increase your site traffic, normally you will target the keywords and bring them to your site. And some of the different type of keywords and also the search terms. And second goal, some of the advertisers, they want to increase the sales or drive the ROI. So compared to the goal of the first one, it's definitely a more difficult goal. So what will they do? First, they decide the KPI, whether they should choose a conversion or a conversion rate. If my goal is to get more people to sign up for my database, then I'll choose the conversions of the database. If my goal is to get people to purchase, then my conversions will be number of purchase. So what is matter here to me will be the landing pages. To get customers to purchase, I need to optimize my landing page, make it attractive for customers to buy from me. And of course, the next one, some of the companies, they would want to raise the brand awareness. So how they measure the brand awareness? The KPI for brand awareness, number one, is the impression. So what is the impression? When you go to the site, you see the search engine page, you probably see many ads. So when you see the ads, you consider contribute one impression to the advertiser. So when you refresh the page, the ads would appear one more time. So impression means that the number of times the ads being displayed. And engagement reach and frequency, how many customers you manage to reach and how frequent they visit your site. And what matters here will be your ads. In order to get people to click your ads, you need to write a very compelling one. So let's look at the ad format. For search ads, these are how the search ads look like. So it consists of the header, display URL, description line 1, and also description line 2. And there's one type of search ads, these are the ads with extensions. What's the purpose of having the ads with extensions? We want to provide additional information so that the customers are more willing to click on our ads compared to other ads available here. So for example, if I have the explanation to explain about the topics for Land series or the C series compared to other advertiser without extension, more of the customer would choose to click my ads rather than the advertiser's ads. And these are the ads without extensions. So, what is the display ad format? We saw just now, display ad format for text ads will look like this. And we also can see from here the display ad format in images. And then we also can have the display ad formats available on mobile apps and of course on other websites. And of course, you can have the display ad formats appear on the YouTube sites. This is normally how the display ads looks like on YouTube and mobile devices. So, beside the ad extension where you can provide additional information, you also can have location extension. Advertisers who run the ads to get more customers, not everyone is in the e-commerce industry. Some of them, they just want to promote their physical store. So what they do, they would drive the traffic to their store and mention about the product, talk about the promotion so that the user will find it interesting enough to walk to their retail store. So what can they do here? To grab the user attention, what they do is to include the location extensions. Location extension here will basically show the map to your physical store. Then you can click to get the directions or view larger map. This one will be very, very useful for the businesses with retail stores or physical locations. And the location extension actually automatically generated from Google Places. So you do not need to create one every time you run the campaign. You just need to go to Google Places and enter your location information, your business information, then Google will automatically pull from the Google Places. And you also have call extensions. Besides going to the physical locations, and you want your customers to call you to find out more from you. So what can you do here? You can display the call button here, and so that customer, they do not need to look for the numbers from you. They can just press the call button and directly contact you. So a call is actually same price as a click, so Google will not charge you more. Basically, it charges you same as the normal click you send to the website. And site links, what we saw just now, you can have more than 2 site links, 4 site links, or even 8 site links here. And seller ratings, to convince the customer to purchase, you probably want to tell them how others rate your product and services. So what can you do here? You can appear, you can display all the ratings available on the third party sources. So Google will just pull the rating from other website and then display it here if you turn on the seller ratings. So social extension. If your company are targeting younger generation where they rely a lot on the social media sites, then you probably want to use social extension from Google Plus page to attract them. So if you turn on the social extension, what will you see here? You will see how many of your friends actually like this page or follow this page. This is to engage people from different generation or different background or different interests. They want to spend more time on the social network. And it's basically linked from Google Plus page. You need to have a Google Plus business page in order to use the social extension. And then you also have offer extensions where you can build the offer. And one more ads, very important here. So Google Shopping ads, we call it product listing ads. In Malaysia, we are not allowed to run product listing ads because Google Shopping is not available in Malaysia. But in other countries, some of the country, in order to attract customers, you know, interest and also grab their attentions, especially for the e-commerce seller, they would use the product listing ads to display the product and services rather than showing the text. So compare this one and this one, which one would grab your attention? It's definitely this one because a seller, what they want to see? They want to see how your products looks like. They want to see how much you are charging them. These are the ads that would get them to take action immediately and find out more from you compared to this one. So, for Google product listing, and only this country on the left available in this country on the left, and then you can appear, you can run the Google product listing and get it appear on Google Shopping and Google Search. But for Google Search only this country can run the product listing ad. So in Malaysia, it's still not available, but we can run the product listing ad targeting international markets, some of the international markets here. So, let's go through some of the scenario questions. It will help us to understand better about the Google advertising. So, which is the benefit of advertising online? Reach people who are likely interested in what you are advertising. Automatically collect information about potential customers. Increase your position in organic search results. Make money by showing ads on your website. What is the answer? B. A. You're right. Yeah. Bear in mind that Google, they follow the Data Privacy Act very strictly, so they are not allowed to collect anyone's personal information. Maybe Gmail, they do collect our information, but for Google Display Ads and Google Search Ads, we don't get any information. We just get the number of clicks, the impressions, click-through rate, and other website metrics. And Google Ads has nothing to do with the organic search result. Remember what we saw in the previous slide? The ads appear on the top, and the right corner, below the top ads, you see a list of search results. That one is the organic search result. So, buying ads will not help to increase the organic search result. And of course, make money by showing ads on your website. You are an advertiser, you pay to run the ads. So you are not a publisher who allocate the advertising space to generate revenue. So next one, what's one of the main benefits of using ad extensions? Remember, we went through a few ad extensions, site link, social extensions, location extensions. So, what is the answer?
C.
Very good. Extensions provide additional information to make your ads more relevant to customers so that they will click your ads rather than advertisers' ads. And extension will not help you to increase your reach by showing your ads on more other advertising network, because now we are only looking at Google advertising network, so it has nothing to do with other advertising network. And extension ensure higher click-through rate because they make your ad more prominent. Extension will not ensure click-through rate, because to get the click-through rate, you need to do more than just inserting extension. You properly need to enhance your ads, correct your ads, or write a better ads to get your customers to click on it. And extensions are automated, so you don't have to create your ads. No, you have to create your ads and you have to add the extensions by yourself. So, which is the benefit of advertising online with Google? Let me check one more time. Okay, which is the benefit of advertising online with Google AdWords? Why not B? Why not D? So the answer is A. Like I mentioned, the difference between the traditional marketing and online marketing, especially the Google marketing, you can control your budget. You are not required to have a preset budget. You can stop your ad anytime. You can increase the budget even by 1,000, 2,000, or 3,000. And for Google AdWords, you cannot choose how many times your ads would show during the day. That is not under your control. And you will not spend the same amount because you are using different keywords. Every keywords you have to spend different amount based on the competition you get. And there's no guarantee that you can show your ads above the organic result. Only those who perform well, follow Google rules, can get the first place. So the answer is A. So, Laura runs an online store with a large inventory of children's toys and games. Which ad format would you use for Laura's campaign to reach people interested in purchasing children's games? So remember the keyword, online store with a large inventory. Which ad format to reach people interested in purchasing? So the answer is yes. Product listing ad. When you see the keywords large inventory, remember we always refer to website selling product and services online. So the best ads to use to target the customer will be the product listing ads. So, if you want to direct people to specific pages on your website from an ad, you can create an ad that uses direct people to specific pages on your website from an ad. So, why not call out, why not locations? Because of the keywords specific pages. So, there is no way you can set up the previous visit extensions that is not available. And what is the call out extensions? Basically, call out extensions allow you to add additional information but without URL. So it's a call out, free shipping, promotion, winter sales, no URL. So it's not the answer for this question because you cannot direct people to specific pages with the call out extensions. And location extensions, you want to drive them to physical store. So this one, the extension is not suitable for specific pages because you will be sending them to Google Maps rather than the specific specific pages. So next one, which of these metrics is especially important to clients who are running a branding campaign? So, wow. So branding here, remember? There are two types of campaign. One is to get the brand awareness, another one is to get the brand, another one is to get the direct response. So there are four stages. Brand awareness is to generate awareness. Direct response is to generate the purchase and sales. So for this one, brandings, we always go for URI. Impressions. So next one, which ad extension would you use for an advertiser who has a chain of restaurant? A chain of restaurant, physical location. Yes. Why not celebrating? Because celebrating is for e-commerce seller, it's not for the business with physical location. And again, there's no such thing as previous visit extension. We cannot track the previous visits and Google will not share it using extension. I'm sure you guys will pass, no worry. Which client would you ever advise to advertise on the Google search network? So take some time to read all the answer. The keyword is Google search network. So you have to know what Google search network means. Remember, you have the search engine and the search partner. Search engine belongs to Google. www.google.com.my or www.google.co.uk. And search partner are those Google Maps, Google Groups, product listing, or non-Google site but using the search engine powered by Google, such as AOL. And which client you want them to use Google search network rather than other networks like display? Is A. Gym who wants to reach people on social networks interested in poetry. A. C. Bill who wants to reach people looking for plumbing services. So the answer is C. First one is definitely out because Google is about search engines, websites, and mobile. So it has it doesn't show your ads on Facebook, Twitter, and other social media sites. So it's not number one. Then B, Susie who wants to reach people browsing travel website about China. Okay, why this one is wrong? Yeah, reach people browsing travel website because that person doesn't use keywords. They are reading the China site, they are reading the travel website, and that one belongs to display. You know, the publisher, they allocate the advertising space, then the advertiser display the ads on the publisher side. And Bill who wants to reach people looking for plumbing services. So how you look for plumbing services? You go to Google and you type the keyword plumbing services. And Carol who wants to reach people watching YouTube video. Why? Okay, yes. Because under display, you can advertise on other people's website and also YouTube and also mobile site. Okay. So, your ads can show on the Google search network when someone searches for terms that are similar to your. Again, the keyword is Google search network. So, someone searches for the terms that are similar to your keywords. So placements belongs to display. So the answer is definitely not placement. And cannot, your website will not appear because you are talking about the Google Ads. It's the paid ads, it's not search engine. So it's not your website that would appear, but the keywords that would appear. Would you choose to advertise on the Google search network if you wanted to? So the keyword here is Google search network again. Yes. A, reach customer browsing website related to your business. That is not the main intention we are using Google. Because there are many ways we can reach the customer, but we want to reach the customer who are actively looking for our product. That's the reason we want to buy the keywords. That's the reason we buy ads. You know, if we are selling smartphone, we want to buy the keywords, buy smartphone. Then we can grab them because they are at the consideration stage. They will buy very fast compared to you are targeting people who are at the awareness stage. You probably need to give them 3 to 6 months. So the answer is B. So now we move to ad rank and quality score. So we know the search term is here and we know how Google rank all the search ads 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now it's very important for us to understand how Google determines the ad positions for competitors and us. So top positions, site rear. AdWords is about auction. So let's say there are 13 positions available. So it depends on how much your competitor bids and how much you bid. That means you set the price you are willing to pay. Then Google decide who should go to the top. So, Google is very smart, unlike other companies where they use the price to determine the ad positions. There are many advertising companies like agency. If you can pay, you can win the positions. And why Google doesn't follow them? Because Google takes care of the quality. They don't want the big player to dominate the search engine page. And it's unfair to the user too because you will not get the real result. You will only get the advertiser who can afford to pay. So let's look at how you can increase your quality and set the bid in order to win the ad position. So, it's not the options that you just bid the highest, you will win. So, before 2005, the formula determine your ad position looked like this. There's a term called ad rank. And how to get ad rank? You have to use maximum CPC times CTR. So let me explain a little bit more about maximum CPC. CPC stands for cost per click. Cost per click for the keyword you purchase. For example, now I want to buy the keywords buy smartphone. So cost per click for smartphone is 50 cents per click. That is the cost per click. But now you have the maximum in front of the cost per click. What does it mean? So you know that cost per click for the keyword is 50 cents. So maximum cost per click refer to the amount you are willing to pay, not the amount charged by Google. So let me explain one more time. Cost per click, the amount charged by Google for the keyword buy smartphone is 50 cents. But the maximum cost per click for the keyword buy smartphone set by you is 1 ringgit. So that is the difference. Now you are referring to maximum cost per click, how much you are willing to pay for a keyword. Every advertiser has own set of budget and they can decide, I think this keyword will get me a lot of money. I want to bid more. I think I have money. Because if I can get the right customers, I will earn 1,000 per customer. So never mind, I'll set the maximum cost per click as 20 ringgit. That's what I said. But how much Google charge you? They don't charge you based on what you said. They charge you based on how you compete with other advertisers. So it might be below 10 ringgit. So you set your maximum 20 ringgit, but Google say, hey, you do well, you have done well. So I think I only charge you 10 ringgit. Well, it can happen. So it depends on how the advertiser improve their ad rank. Okay, so what is click-through rate? Click-through rate is a very, very important metric. So you have impression, you have click. So if you look at the impression, it means that the number of times your ads being displayed. Imagine you go to the Google search engine, you see the ads. Buy smartphone, there's one ad appear from Samsung, right? So the ad appear means that one impression generated. So let me give you an example. I'm customer A. I go to the Google site, I type the keyword buy smartphone. Samsung ad appear. So I contribute one impression to Samsung ad because I see the ads. Customer B, go to the search engine site, type the same keyword, buy smartphone, and Samsung ads appear again. So customer B contribute one impressions to the ads. Every time the ads being displayed, it generate impression. That's how we call impression. Impression means that you have customers searching for your ads, but have they clicked? No, they have not clicked. Just that the ads appear. You can give a try. You can go to Google search engine and just type a few keywords. For example, corporate gifts is a very competitive keywords. Or you can type gifts, or you can type any keywords, flowers, jobs. Yeah. Then every time you type the keywords, all the ads appear. That means you just generate impressions. You are not contributing any clicks because you haven't clicked any of the ads. So click-through rate means that how many people who have seen your ads actually click. So the formula of click-through rate, we get the number of clicks divided by impression. So let's imagine, okay, now Samsung ads, the impression is very high. You have 1,000 people seeing the ads, but only 500 click the ad. So how to get the click-through rate? Yes, 500 divided by 1,000. And why you have to refer to the click-through rate? Google is very, very smart. Because they know that if your click-through rate is higher, it means that you are writing a very relevant ad, right? So if today I'm searching for buy smartphone, and if you show me the ads buying flower, will I click? You can continue to show me the ads, but I will not click because I want to look for flowers. I don't want to look for smartphone. So how to find out, how to check whether the advertiser, they really give the customers relevant information? Google use the click-through rate to determine whether they follow the rules. So this is the formula before 2005. So let's look at the next one. So after 2005, Google improved again because they really want to control the advertiser. They don't want advertiser just spend money and give us the fake URL, wrong information. Because you know what Google care about? Google care about the user. Google care about your experience. Google care about whether you can get the right information from Google. That's how they become number one for so many years in this world. So they improve the ad rank formula. So now after 2005, ad rank formula became maximum CPC times quality score. They don't use click-through rate, they use quality score. So we will cover quality score later in more detail, but let me share with you what is quality score. Basically, every keyword is assigned a value. So let's say buy smartphone. Google will assign a value for this keyword, and the value start from 1 to 10. 1 being the poorest, 10 to it being the best. So if you get 1 for your keyword, it means that you are doing a very bad job for this keyword. If you get 10, that means you are doing a very good job. The keyword is very relevant. The keyword is what the user are looking for, what the customer are looking for. This is how Google determines the quality of your keyword. So every keyword is assigned with a value. That's called quality score. Then after that, Google has improved again the ad rank formula. Now it becomes this one. It's no longer maximum CPC times quality score. It's the maximum CPC times quality score plus ad extensions and format. That's why just now we cover ad extensions. And again, why we need to remember this formula? Because of ad rank. If you get higher ad rank, that means that you can go to the highest position with the lowest budget. That is the unique formula invented by Google. You look at any advertising platforms, which company will give you the highest position with lowest budget? No one. Every company, every agency, every advertising provider, they want money. They want to get your money. They want you to pay more so that they can earn more. But for Google, they play the game differently. They want to make sure that you put your effort to give the best to your customers. Then they will reward you with high position level with low cost. Yeah. So now they add one more thing, which is the ad extensions and format. They want to encourage the advertiser to use ad extension. Why? Because you can provide additional information to your customer. So the information, if you use the site link to provide the information and the customer look at it and they feel that it's not what they are looking for, then they won't click. But if the site link give them additional information, help them to make the decision, of course they will click. And they like it. And then this is the formula for the ad rank. So what is the bid? Just now we talk about auctions, we talk about bid this, bid that. So bid is actually similar to the maximum cost per click. How much you want to bid. So when you go to eBay, I want to bid for a pair of shoes. $10. Does it mean that you pay 10? No, you can be paying lower or paying higher. So here you are looking at maximum CPC and also the daily budget. It's very important to know these two metrics because when you come out, you have your first job, let's say you are given a task by your management. So help me to run a campaign and I give you a set of budget. So how much I'm going to give you? Maybe I just want to give you a 300 or 500 per month or 1000 per month, and let's see what you can get from me. So when you get a budget, right, the first thing you need to do, especially for the online campaign, you break down by the number of days. You need to know your daily budget. So if you have a set of budget for a month, let's say it's 100 for 30 days, so how much you will get a month? Sorry, how much you will get per day? So 100 for 30 days. 3 point. Sorry? So, remember when you get your monthly budget given by the management, normally management will give you the monthly budget, you just need to divide by 30.4 to get the daily budget. You need to know your daily budget well. Oh, sorry, I need to go back here. So once you know your daily budget, then you can set the maximum cost per click for your bids. So let's say you have the daily budget of 100 daily budget, then the cost per click, how much you are willing to pay for a click? 100, if you want to pay for a click, you know, maximum CPC is 1 ringgit, that means one day you only get 100 clicks. That is how you predict your result, because everything can be calculated. So if you have a daily budget, if you have a monthly budget, you convert to, you divide by 30.4, make it a daily budget. Once you have the daily budget, you look at how many clicks can you get, whether you should lower your cost per click or get more budget. So one day 100, some advertiser might think it's good, but for some advertiser they might think that it's too little. One day I only have 100 people visiting my site, so I want more people. So what you can do, you can optimize your keywords, the bids, and then lower it down. Maybe from one ringgit I set to 50 cents, then you will get more clicks. Yeah, that is how you work around the budget. And understand, manage the expectations, how much money you spend with how many clicks you can get. And if you feel that you need more than 100% per day in order to generate the conversions, then you need to optimize your bid, you need to lower your maximum cost per click. So now we are looking at quality score. These are the three components determine quality score. Remember, quality score is one of the component for ad rank. Now we are looking at how to improve our quality score first. Ad ranks equals to the previous slide. Maximum CPC times quality score times ad extension and format. This one has to go up, then the ad rank will go up.
Does the extensions cost more money?
Extensions actually will not cost more money. Extension will not cost more money. What costs more money is the position going up. That is the position. So many people, when they run the extension ads, right, they feel that, especially the experienced advertiser, they feel that extension get more money. Because you have the extension, you tend to get more customer to notice your ad, click your ad. Of course, you can spend your budget faster. So extension is not more expensive than the normal ads. And it doesn't mean that they click the extension, you have to pay extra. No, if they click the extension, it's actually same as they click your ad. So quality score, there are three components. In order to achieve high quality score, what you need to do? First, you need to increase the click-through rate. Second, you need to increase the ad relevancy. Third, you need to improve the landing page. We go back to the first one, click-through rate. Number of clicks divided number of impressions. How would you increase the click-through rate? So you can increase the click-through rate by optimizing your ads. So let's say, again, use the same example, buy smartphone, the Samsung ads. So Samsung ads, if they don't have the smartphone keyword, they probably want to talk more about smartphone. They probably want to talk about the promotion. They want to make sure that users who are looking for smartphone ads, when they see their ads, they know they are talking about smartphone. That would help to increase the click-through rate. So when you are selling flowers online and your user, they are searching for flowers. So if they are searching for roses, you probably want to include the keywords in your text app, rather than saying flowers, you change it, you put roses. That's how you increase the click-through rate. Remember what the user want and include the important keywords in the text app. Make sure they understand. Then the second thing, add relevancy. Okay, let's go back to the click-through rate. Okay, Google, how Google measure your click-through rate? Your click-through rate is not just measured based on one ad. Your click-through rate is also measured on the historical performance. That means in the past, how well you perform. Because Google doesn't just take, you know, today's click-through rate and to determine your performance. So all the while, if you are performing good, then Google know that your click-through rate can remain high. And then, of course, the keyword click-through rate will be what the example I gave to you just now. Look at the keywords you are using, whether it's relevant to your ads. If you are selling the smartphone, use the keyword like purchase smartphone, buy smartphone. Don't use other keywords. For example, smartphone, if you use phone, maybe it's not as relevant as smartphone because they are looking for a smartphone. So you have to take note of the type of keywords you are using. Be very, very relevant. Then the ad relevancy, try to improve it, try to make the user understand. The more relevant your ad is, the more they will click, the higher chance for them to click your ads. And the last one, which is very important, will be the landing page. What is the landing page? The landing page can be a website with a page for the campaign. So let's say I own the Samsung site, then I create a landing page, just a one page to show all the smartphone. So that when I run the campaign to promote the smartphone, the user click the ads, I will land them on the landing page where they can see all the smartphones available. That is called a very targeted landing page on the Samsung site. So if today I run the online flower shop, but I land my user who are searching for roses to a landing page with lilies, that means the landing page is not targeted. The quality is low because you are not giving your user the relevant information they are looking for. That is how Google controls the quality. You must be relevant, you must give the right information to keep experience of the user continue using search engine, continue using Google for their daily uses. Beside the information on the landing page, you have to be careful of the load time, how long it takes for the user to go to that page. If it is too long, they have to wait for 1 minute, that means you are giving them a very poor experience. And Google doesn't like it. They want you to make sure that your landing page is easy to access. It's fast to access, it only takes a few seconds and for them to go to the landing page. And they want you to make sure that it's very easy to navigate your landing page. You have the call to action button, you don't simply leave them there and they do not know where to go. You must guide them. For example, you look for this information, click the button, the copy has to make sense. These are the small components that make a very good landing page. And of course, transparent is very important. That's how you control the information. You have to be honest about your product. You have to give them enough information so that they can justify the purchase, so that they know how to take the next action. And that's how you increase the quality score. Any company with a very high quality score, 7, 8 or 9, I seldom see companies with 10 of quality score, they normally follow all these rules. You can see from the site, the ads they are writing, the landing page they use, very targeted, informative, transparent, and of course, the click-through rate, the copy and everything. They put everything properly and make sure that they follow the rules set by Google, which is the relevancy of the information and the ads. So one being poor, then being great. So most of the company, especially those who just start the Google campaign, right, they won't see the keyword with the quality score of 7. They would normally get lower, 5, 3. Then it's your job as the advertiser to improve it by following the rules here.
How is the landing page rating assessed?
Okay. Google has a secret formula to rate all this. So you do not know the weightage. So they will not reveal to you. So it depends on them. They have a set of formula where they can monitor your website using the particular set of formula and rate that to you. So many advertisers, they try to find out the formula, but after so many years, no one knows about the formula. That makes it fun, right? Because that is, you know, something you guess, you try to do, you try to improve, but you realize that, oh, it's not the way. But everyone who are into Google AdWords, right, they continuously improve themselves, learning new things, because Google always change to improve for better results. So you learn together with Google. It's a very rewarding experience. So let's go through some scenario questions for AdRank. And sorry, before that, let's go to the how to improve your quality score, the action plan. Just now we talked about, you know, some of the more strategic plan. Now we look at what we really can do. Organize your account for maximum effectiveness, number one. So we will cover this later. So basically, they want you to group your account into the similar themes. That means every account, every web page have their own themes. And I'll talk about it later. Then second one, choose relevant keywords. Drive strong CTR across keywords. Remember what business you are doing, what products you are selling. If you are selling flowers, don't choose a smartphone keywords. If you are selling smartphone, don't choose the flower keywords. Always be relevant. And the third one, clear link from ads and landing page. Your ads should have a display URL. You must let them know where should they go. So when they click the ads, you must land them to a proper design landing page with a clear call to action so they know what step they are going to take. You cannot leave them there without any information and they do not know what to do at all. Then number four, point user to a landing page with relevant original content with quick load time. So, as mentioned just now, landing page has to be relevant. And Google will penalize you if you use the content of others. You cannot copy others' content. You have to write the original content. And you have to have the quick load time. Relevant, original, transparent. And the next one, ROTN, navigable, yeah, very good. So let's look at one example. If all of them are bidding on the same keyword, who will win the top position? So you have John here, then you have Dave here, and you have Alex here. So John's maximum CPC is 1, and quality score is 8. So I press this one, you know it's 8. So Dave's CPC is 1, quality score is 10. So this one is 10. So this one, Alex, maximum CPC is 2.35, and quality score is 3. 7. So remember what we said just now? Ad rank determines your position. So if you look at the ad rank, which one will have highest ad position? They are bidding on the same keyword. So the third one is Alex. Second one is John. Then the first one is Dave. So for Alex, they bid 2.35. It's higher than the rest. But too bad, his quality score is the lowest. That's why it pulled down the overall ad rank performance. So next question: if I'm bidding 5, will I pay 5? No. So, how much will you pay? So now let's look at the actual CPC, another set of formulas. So at rank of the next competitor divided by your quality score plus the 0.01 will be your actual CPC. All can be calculated. Remember, you set your maximum CPC, let's say 10 ringgit, but it is not your actual CPC. But you can calculate your actual CPC by using this formula. So let's look at this example. Let's try to calculate the actual CPC. So you have Dave with the app rank of 10, maximum CPC of 1, and quality score of 10. So what you use? Who is Dave's next competitor? John. So you use the at rank of the next competitor divided by quality score of Dave, then plus a 0.01. Then you get the 81 cents. Then you look at the John. So John, who is John's next competitor? Alex. So you get Alex at rank, which is 7, divided by quality score of 8, then plus 0.01. Then how about next one? How you calculate? You don't have at rank. Can you calculate? No, because you need the at rank of your next competitor, then you only can calculate your actual CPC. But no matter how, Alex still have to pay the minimum options price. So there is a minimum bid set by Google, then Alex just need to follow that. So where can you find your quality score? How does your quality score look like? So when you go to the Google AdWords reports, right, then you will see the keywords. You see the word keywords, the ad group, and these are the performance. You actually can know the performance for each single keyword. So you have how many clicks for keyword 1, how many impressions generate, and the click-through rate using the number of clicks divided by the impressions, and for next keyword and the next keyword. And to check your quality score, you can get from, there's one column here, quality score. It shows you that out of these 3 keywords, this one has the highest. That's how you check the quality score. If you have the quality score for many keywords which are below 5, then it's time for you to improve your quality score, because it will pull down your overall performance. Yeah. So quality score, when you go to Google AdWords, right, quality score is not the default setting. So you need to customize the column, and then so that it will show you additional column. I can demonstrate to you during lunch. During break. Then of course when you modify the columns, you go to, you know, attribute, performance, conversion, attributions, bid simulator, and competitive metrics, and it's under the attributes one. Then you will see other metrics, but you just need to select this one, add this one, then you will see on your report page, which is your interface. Where to find your average ad position? Now you know where to get the quality score. You will be able to know the quality score for each keyword. So now you want to find your ad position, right? I think all the advertisers, they are interested to know how well that their ad perform, how many people they need to compete with, whether they climb to number one positions, or they are at the 9th or 10th position. So to see your average position is on the default setting, so you do not need to customize the columns or modify the columns. You can just look at the average position here. So it shows that for this keyword, the ad positions are pretty good, ranking number one, ad positions number one. But normally for advertisers with many keywords, right, they will not see average position of number one here. They will see a 3, 4, 5. It's very competitive. Yeah. So to improve your ad position, increase your bid, and improve the quality of your ads, which is the ad rank formula. Remember? Every time you run the ads, you buy a keyword on Google search, you are competing for a position with other advertisers who are buying the same keywords. You need to understand the ad rank formula so that you can improve your ad rank, to improve your ranking with lower cost. You want to be able to climb up, perform better, but still with the same cost, not paying extra to get to the top position. Then, maximum CPC is not necessarily what you pay for a click. Maximum is what you are willing to pay for. Actual CPC will be another formula. Charge the actual amount you charge by Google. The higher your quality score, the less you will pay. That's the reason why we need to continuously increase our ad rank. Use relevant ad extensions to win the auctions. It's all about relevancy. If you please your user well, Google will reward you because they want you to give the best experience to your user and customers. Okay, some scenario questions. Which of the following items is not a component of quality score? Three components, right? So,
expected picture rate,
quality score and ad rank are different. So, it's not a component of quality score. So which one is not a component? Yeah, because this one belongs to ad rank. It's not the quality score. Quality score, you have three components. Which are the landing page experience, ad relevance, and expected click-through rate. You can win a higher ad position in the auction with a lower cost per click bid buy. Win a higher ad position with a lower cost per click. That means if you improve your ad rank, then you can win the higher ad position with a lower cost. And how to improve your ad rank? Very smart. So for ad rank formula is the maximum CPC times maximum CPC times quality score times ad extensions and format. Okay, so this one is out, not using ad extension. And this one is also out. When you see the keyword generic, it's wrong answer. Because the right keyword is always relevant. Yeah. Create ads that includes terms or phrases people are searching for is not enough for you to improve your ad rank. So the answer is, you must have the relevant keywords and ads and using ad extensions. Yep. Next one. Every time your ad is eligible to show, AdWords calculates its ad rank using your bid amount, components of quality score, and calculates its ad rank using bid amount, which is the maximum CPC, quality score, and the last one is very good, expected impact of extensions and other ad formats. An advertiser wants to increase the quality score of a low performing keyword. Which approach would you recommend? So increase quality score of a low performing keywords. Remember the three components of quality score. Then now you have the keyword low performing keyword. So what is the answer? Yeah, you don't repeat the keywords. A is wrong, because if you repeat your keywords, your ads won't make sense, your landing page won't make sense. You cannot have flower on all the page. Yeah. So, and you also don't delete the keyword and add keyword. you have a keyword with quality score. Let's say you have been running the campaign for 3 months, now your quality score for flower is 6, which is considered not bad. If today you delete the keyword, then you add a new one, then you have to start all over again. And then increase the daily budget for campaign is not helping you to increase the quality score. It's not about the budget, the money. An advertiser wants to achieve the top position in paid search result. Which recommendations would improve the likelihood of top position? Paid search result. So this one is the Google search ads. A. Why not D? Why A? So a tip for you. So every time if you encounter a question ask you, you know, how can you improve the performance of a low performance keywords or campaign, right? Always remember, go for the answer which asks you to increase the cost per click. Okay, that is the right answer. Improve quality score and increase the cost per click. You are right. Next one, higher quality score typically result in lower cost and better ad positions. If it is higher cost and lower ad position, I don't think anyone wants to use Google. Next one, your client wants to improve her ad position. What would you recommend? Ad position. Yeah, remember what I said just now? So always choose the increased bid amount. That is the right answer. What happens as a result of a search campaign consistently meeting its daily budget? So let's say you allocate 100 per day, 100 as your daily budget, and every day you are spending 99 ringgit. So what happens if you have the campaign, you spend almost all your daily budget? Sorry? Any other answers? Okay. So the answer is B. It's not B because you are you result of a search campaign, you meet your daily budget, but it doesn't affect your cost per click. You still continue paying the cost per click based on the competition, the performance you have done for your keyword and ad. So that one wouldn't affect if you spend 90% of your budget or 80% of your budget. But the problem here is if you are spending 90% or 99% and you are not increasing your budget, you are missing people who are looking for your product and services. That's because there are many people who are looking for your product, that's why you can spend. If you are targeting in a very niche market, you try to spend 100 ringgit, sometimes you don't even spend 50 ringgit. You must have people looking for your product, that's why they click. And so for Google, right, they always encourage you to increase your budget if you notice that you are running out of budget. That means that they want you to grab those very potential customers, especially for the Western countries, the advertiser from the Western country. During the Christmas season, they always want to increase the daily budget so that they can convert more customers. So, all other things being equal, if you have set a maximum CPC bid of $1 for your ads or 1 ringgit for your ads, and if the next competitive bid is 50 cent for the same ads position, what is the actual amount you would pay for that click? Wow. Okay, remember the formula for actual CPC? So that would be the ad rank of the next competitor divided by quality score of yours plus 0.01. So the answer is 0.01. Just add the 0.01. That's right. An advertiser has decided that they want to spend 608 per month for their campaign. How would you recommend they set their budget in their AdWords account? 608 per month. Yeah, so you are given a monthly budget, so you have to divide, yeah, to get the daily budget. Sorry? It's the campaign, not account. One account can have multiple campaigns. So we are talking about one campaign here. 608 per month for their campaign. Because when you set the budget, right, you don't set at the account level, you set at the campaign level. Let's say you own the account with the account number 1234. So you can have multiple campaigns. So this campaign you set at 608. So when someone clicks your ad, the actual amount you are charged will be? Remember how Google charges you? So don't get confused by the 51 cent. It has nothing to do with the 51 cent. So you just need to remember, it's the minimum needed to hold your ad position. That's why you have the formula for actual CPC. They just look at your next competitor's ad rank, then they charge you 0.01. So as long as you set the budget, you set the maximum cost per click, Google will not exceed your budget. They will just, and they will not, because of you set a 10 ringgit budget, so I should 10 ringgit bid, so I should charge you 9 ringgit. No, depends on of your performance and your next competitor's performance. So now we look at account structure. Before we learn, okay, so let's take a 15 minutes break first. We come back because this one we have a few slides. So take a break first, then we come back. So now we will learn how to create our very first Google AdWords campaign. Very first. Of course, we create virtually, but after the class, if you have any question you would like to see how the interface look like, always can ask me questions. And just to let you know that in Malaysia, right, there are many people who do not know how to run the Google AdWords campaign. I think only maybe less than 10% or 20% know how to run it. So if you know, you absolutely stand a higher chance compared to them. Yeah. So before we start any campaign, it's very important to know the goals. Your business goal, your marketing goals, if you want to run a campaign. And it depends on your industry and what you are selling. What is the most important for you and for this campaign, what you plan to achieve. So, ask yourself a few questions. What is the marketing objective? Whether it is a increased awareness campaign, or it is a direct response campaign. And understand your target customer. Who are you trying to reach? Are you trying to reach youngster, teenagers? Or you are trying to reach mothers? Or you are trying to reach senior citizens? It's very important to define that. And what does success look like? So you want to get which type of conversions? It should be a purchase conversion, or it should be just the impression or clicks conversions. And the next one, what action are you driving towards your website? What action you need them to take when they go to your website? So how do you measure success? Google AdWords, if you run the campaign, you can measure success in many, many ways. So you can measure the number of purchases, how many purchase from your site, 10 of them a day, 50 of them a day, not just the purchases, but with the value. You know the revenue. Today, you get 10 purchases, then how much you are earning per day. You will know that. Those can be tracked. Then you can also measure the lead form, the lead generation. Some of the campaigns, they focus on lead generation. They want to get customers to fill in the information and send them the information. For example, the B2B and B2C. A B2C business, business to customers business, normally you get people to ask about your product, so they will send you a contact form. That is the B2C. But for B2B, your corporate customers, other businesses who want to buy your product, they will also leave their contact with you. That is one type of lead generations. And the next one, if you are an event company owner and you just want more people to subscribe for your e-newsletter so that you can inform them about the event, about the upcoming event. So your goal should be the number of newsletter sign up. And how about the companies like maybe a technology company or company who who help the clients to run campaigns, the agencies, you want them to know about your portfolio or case study. So what you want them to do? You want them to download your PDF of your company, of the case study, of your portfolio. And of course, if you have a site targeting the teenagers, the best way to engage with them is definitely to use video or games. So you probably want to set your goal as how many minutes watching a video, how long they watch your video, and you want to find out how well you engage with them. If they only spend a few seconds, that means the video is not working. If they spend more than 1 minute or they watch the whole video, you are achieving your goal. So Google AdWords advertising platform, you will go to www.google.com.my/AdWords, then you just go to sign in. So setting up the new account, first thing you do, assume that you don't have an account, setting up a new account, you need to use your own Google login to sign in. Then you have to select the time zone, which cannot be changed in the future. So if I'm running the business in Malaysia, my time zone should be follow Malaysia one. If I'm running the business in Malaysia and they are going to pay me in ringgit, I should set my currency as Malaysia ringgit. So these two cannot be changed. You have to decide the moment you want to set up your AdWords campaign. And of course, you have to set up the billing. Advertiser, they can choose. They want to go for prepay or postpay. They pay first or they pay later. Or they want to use a bank account, credit or debit card. And of course, if you own the Google AdWords account, you can grant access to your colleagues or other users. For example, in the company, they will set up the Google account for company and they will grant the access, for example, marketing department. The staff under marketing department, they will have access to log into Google account to measure the performance. This all can be done on Google AdWords. So let's look at how to set up the account. Hierarchy is very important. That's the first thing. So you own an account, can be your personal account or company account. You need to have the unique email address and password and billing information. One account, when you just set up the account, you don't have any campaigns. But you can create campaigns. More than one campaigns, one campaign, more than one campaigns, 20 campaigns, 50 campaigns. Multiple campaigns under each AdWords account. So when you create a campaign, assume that now you want to create two campaigns. So what are the information you need for your campaign? You need to set the budget. If you have a monthly budget, then you just need to divide by 30.4 and to insert the daily budget. Then you have to decide your location, which country you are targeting. So if you want to sell to UK, then you choose United Kingdom. Then you have to decide your language targeting. You want to target people who are you know, reading in Chinese, English, or Malay. So you look at your browser, let's say you are using Chrome, are you looking at the Chinese words on your browser or English word? That is the language selected by each of us. From China, they normally will set their browser to simplified Chinese. For Hong Kong, they will set to traditional Chinese. If you need to target people from Hong Kong, then you have to select the language targeting to traditional Chinese rather than other languages. Then you decide the network. Remember what we learned just now? You want to go for search network or display network. Then you decide now. Then you can decide other things, for example, the ad rotation. How frequently you want to rotate your ad, how fast you want to rotate your ads, and then we can decide on the bid strategy. We will cover this later, different type of bid strategy getting you different results. And of course, the extension, the ad extension we covered just now, and the end date. You want to run the campaign, you want to start by today, or you want to schedule a date and run it for how long? Is it a 2 weeks campaign, 1 month campaigns, 6 month campaigns? You decide. Under each campaign, you can have ad groups. So you start with account, then you create the campaign, put all the information required. After you enter all the information, Google will ask you, okay, now is the time to create the ad group. So you can create multiple ad group under each campaign. So what information do you need for each ad group? You need your keywords, of course, because you are buying keywords. Then you need your ads. If you are buying keywords by smartphone, you probably want to write the ads, you know. The cheapest, not cheapest, most affordable smartphone or the latest smartphone to attract their attentions. Then, of course, you want to use some bid modifier. We will cover this later to help you to optimize your performance. So, one AdWords account can have multiple campaigns, but each campaign can have multiple ad groups. And each ad groups, you will have to enter the keywords, ads, and other device settings. So now we look at the account. Oh, sorry. So at the account level, you can manage the user access. You want to grant this account to how many users at different type of access level. They can edit the text, edit the campaign, or they just allow a view access only. Then you will have notifications. Sometimes Google wants to notify you about the changes, about the service time, and you can have the billing information, and of course you can have other preferences. Then at the campaign, what you can manage? You can manage your daily budget. You can manage your bidding style, how you want to bid your ads. And you can manage your network targeting, location language targeting. Bid adjustment is an advanced bidding strategy. So you can adjust your bid based on just the location, device, or the ad rotation as scheduling. For example, My customers, they are from Hong Kong. So if I have any customers from Hong Kong, I want to increase the bids from 50 cents to 2 ringgit. That is just for Hong Kong. I adjust by bid based on location. Or my customers, they like to use mobile devices to reach my page. So I want to adjust my bid. If I have customer using mobile devices to reach me, I want to compete with other competitors. So I will increase from 1 ringgit to 2.5 ringgit based on the devices they use to visit my site. And ad rotation and scheduling, and depends on the day of the week, Monday to Sunday. So my customers always come to visit my site and make the purchase every Wednesday. So every Wednesday I want to adjust my bid from a 2 ringgit to 3 ringgit 50 cent. That is the bid adjustment you can do at the campaign level. So ad group, what you can manage at the ad group level? Manage the keywords, manage the match types, and manage the copy, and of course for display, you can manage the targeting options and also the ad creative. Ad creative here refers to different type of ads. It can be a normal image ads, it can be a video ads, it can be ads with the rollover, the rich media ads. So targeting options on display. As you know, if you are running a display campaign, you are actually displaying your ads on the publisher side. Remember, they will allocate the advertising space either on the top, at the bottom, in the middle, at the right, for you to display your ads. But one thing you can get from the display targeting would be to choose your target audience. So targeting options here means that you can decide which type of audience you want to target. Maybe you want to target customers who are interested in properties, or you want to target customer who wants to get them a new bicycle, so they are browsing the bicycle website. So these are the settings available on display network. So budget. So we know the budget, the amount on average you like to spend every day. And you have two options how to spend your budget. That is the flexibility given by Google. You want to spend it very fast, or you want to spread evenly throughout the day. If you have a 100 ringgit budget, so which one should you choose? Standard? Why you want to choose standard? Because you don't have enough budget? And why not accelerated? Remember the campaign objective? What you plan to achieve for this campaign? So you want to generate awareness, or you want to get the purchase? So let's say for the campaign, they just want to generate awareness. I don't expect you to take the purchase decision. I just want you to know my brand. I just want you to know that I have an event next week. So I want more people to see me. So for that type of campaign, normally they will go for accelerated, because you get more people to know your event, know your promotion, know about your company name. You do it quick. For people to know your brand, to click, to read the ad, it's faster than for people to make the purchase. But for some other people, right, they know that the customers will not decide immediately. You want to get a purchase. If you spend your money in the morning, right, you might miss out the customer who only come to visit your site in the afternoon or day at night. So if you know your customer behavior well, right, you won't simply spend all the budget in the morning. You know that, for example, if you are selling a milk powder, you know mothers, they only available after 10 p.m. after they put their babies to sleep. Do you want to spend all your budget in the morning? No, you want to leave it at night. So it depends on how well you understand your customers too. So budget-wise, if you have money and you are targeting to generate more awareness, always go for the accelerator. If you are a direct response campaign, you are running a direct response campaign, you want to get more people to take action rather than just seeing your ads, go for standard so that you can spread evenly throughout the day, so that you don't miss out the customer visiting your site after morning or at night. Then you can set the share budget that is for the agency with multiple clients. Normally they will do the share budget. So setting and managing budget. So once you choose the standard delivery, right, you have to understand that standard delivery means that you let Google control when they should display your ad. So it doesn't mean that I set standard, so in the morning you have to display 30%, then in the afternoon another 30%, at night 40%. So you actually pass the control to them. They will decide when they would display your ads. And accelerate delivery, normally they do it as soon as possible. So if you run out of budget, you don't expect to see your ads after the budget is spent. So target ads by language and location. Just now we mentioned about the language targeting. So when you log into Google, they will give you all languages here. Depends on the customer you are targeting. Targeting Malaysian, you probably want to choose English. Then you can choose Malay. Do we have Malay here? M. No. Then you choose Chinese. Chinese has to be Chinese, simplified Chinese. So if you are in the UK, you want to target UK customer, then you just go for English. Or you are in Taiwan, you want to target Taiwanese customer, you will go for Chinese traditionals. This is your user interface language. Then location targeting, you can target by country, by region, by city. So how does AdWords detect user locations? Very good. IP address is one of them. So you can also detect from google.com.sg. You know, like in Malaysia, normally we will go to google.com.my. So automatically we will be transferred to, redirected to google.com.my. And of course, your mobile device location will share your location to Google. And of course, this is a very technical way query to detect the user locations. Basically, it's the IP and domain that help Google to detect our locations. So, several levels to specify. Beside country, region, city, you can also set by zip code and radius targeting. Radius targeting is very effective for businesses with retail store or businesses that only want to serve the neighborhood, customer from the neighborhood. They do not need to target the whole Kuala Lumpur. They probably want to target the radius, you know, 30 miles from where they are located at. That is how we help the businesses to be very targeted, not to waste their money. Focus on the customers they want to get. If you try to target at city or region level, you have to always increase your budget because there will be more people to click your ad. So if you want to utilize your budget, always look at where are your target audience and focus on the area which will give you the highest conversion. So many businesses in Malaysia, they only choose a few locations. What are the locations? Kuala Lumpur, PJ, Penang, JB or Johor. These are the key locations where the customer from this location can spend more than other locations. And I don't think there are many businesses or many advertisers would target the whole Malaysia. It's really hard to manage. You need to have a very high budget because you will get anyone from anywhere in Malaysia to click your ads, and you are not sure whether they are looking for the similar product or they are just clicking to find out more information and have no intention to buy from you. So, ad extension we mentioned just now, social extension, location extension, and site link extension. So, this is how the site link extension look like. Social extension is here. Has how many followers on Google Plus? Social extension is only for Google Plus, and you need to set up the Google Plus business account. And you have the location extension here. Apparently this company, they try to target the customers, you know, from the customers to go to their website using the site link and to go to the physical location using the location extension and to go to their Google Plus page or to get more information from their Google Plus page using the social and extension to inform the customers. And they also have the phone extension here. Yeah. So setting up your first campaign, when you log into Google, you will see the button plus campaign, the red one. So you just click that and how you should name your campaign. So remember what you can manage at the campaign level. So you probably can, no, you have to choose which network you go for, then you have to choose your country, then you have to decide what the campaign is all about. So when you name your campaign, I would suggest you to go for the network first. So if this is a search network, you can use this one, SRCH, or for me, I always put search. Then put hyphen, and where are you targeting? If you are targeting Malaysia, you just put MY. So you can also set the language. For example, you will have multiple campaigns in Malaysia. One is in Chinese, another one is in Malay. So here you can just put a dash English, then that can be the campaign name, can be a promo, can be a sales, can be an event campaign. This is how you want to set up your campaign name. Why? Because you will have more than one campaign. And how can you identify which campaigns belong to this country? So you name it properly. When you log into your Google interface, then you just look at the campaign names, you will know your campaigns well. So when you click the plus campaign button, you will see the options here. Search network with display select, search network only, display network only, shopping. Okay. There are two types of network, one is search, another one is display. So, but there is one option you can do. You can set the search network using one campaign, display network using another campaign, or you can set one campaign with both search and display. So, in what scenario you want to go for the campaign in search and display separately, and in what scenario you want to go for the search network with display campaign. When you want to separate two of them and when you want to mix them up. Why? So, I'll give you an example. When you have not enough budget, you only have 100 per day, and you need to run search campaign and display campaign. So if you have 100, that means one network only can give 50 ringgit, another display network you give 50 ringgit. So in total, you will have 100. But you feel that you don't want to reduce the budget to 50 because you will not generate enough click. So what you do? You create only one campaign. So that one campaign, you combine search with display when you don't have enough budget. But let's say if you have enough budget, most of the advertisers, they would prefer to separate the campaign into search and display. They don't want to mix it up. Why? Because it will help them to measure accurately. You know that this number of purchase, let's say after you run the campaign, you get 60 purchase compared to 3 purchase before the campaign. Then you know, okay, 60 purchase out of the 60, maybe 40 comes from search campaign. Then another 20 comes from display campaign. You can measure separately. But when you mix it up, right, then you do not know which network contributes higher purchase to your site. You probably have to guess. Maybe search gives me more purchase, or display gives me more purchase. And the last one, the shopping, that is the product listing ads we saw just now. So the ads which will show your product images with the prices on the Google search page. So, after you select the option, let's say you go for a search campaign, then you have to do multiple selections now. So you have to go for standard or all features. If you are a new campaign advertiser, this is your first campaign, normally I'll suggest you to go for standard first. Don't do so many settings. Learn how to run the basic campaign. Or you are the experienced advertiser, you want to do additional setting, you want to schedule your ad only want to appear during Wednesday and other days, you want to adjust a bit, then you have to go for the all features. Of course, for search network, there are additional options available here. You can use search network to target mobile app install. You also can use Google Ads to get the mobile apps installed, or mobile apps engagement, encourage the actions to your mobile app, or dynamic search ads, or call-only ads. These are the additional strategy provided by search. And now we go to the display campaign. So display campaign, it depends on your objective. Display campaign can help you to target different type of audience, whether they are looking on the different type of website, or they want to find out different type of information. So you select the marketing objective, then you decide. Should you go for the setting with advanced setting, or you just go for the ads in the mobile apps? And of course, the search network with display select. Again, same. New advertiser, go for the standard first, until you learn how to manage your campaign. Experience one, go for all features and make the changes. I'll give you an example here. So imagine that Vivian, she owns a little cottage. So what is she selling? She's selling flowers, drinkware, home decor items, and she targets her customers. She gets her customers to buy during important occasions. Flowers, Valentine's Day, drinkware like champagne flutes you buy as a wedding gifts, or birthday, or housewarming day. So these are the items she is selling. So what are the keywords she will be using? So remember what she's selling? Flowers, drinkware, and home decor. So she would have the keywords of the product she's selling, like champagne flutes, jasmine, roses, lilies, jugs and pitchers, wine glasses, candle stand, incense burner, tankard, teapot. These are the products she's selling, and under the category of flowers, then home decor and drinkware. So she has gathered, she has written down all her keywords here. Then how should she group her keywords and also create the campaigns and ad groups? So now you look at the organizing structure. You have the Vivian's Little Cottage. So how should you group all the keywords? You should group all the keywords under the similar themes. We call it themes. Themes here means that if you are selling flowers, you cannot be just selling one type of flowers. You definitely have a few types. So you want to put the keywords of a few type of flowers under the theme of flowers. And then you have the drinkware you are selling, and you want to group them together and put it under drinkware. And of course the home decor item, photo frames, incense burner, tea light holder, vases and jugs and pitchers, you put them under home decor and the occasions. Occasions are very important keywords for her business because she will get customers to buy from her during important occasions like wedding days, Valentine's, housewarming, anniversary gifts. You can give them, you can give your loved one the champagne flutes or trinket balls, and then birthday. So this is how she will group her keywords under four themes. And why she needs to group her keywords under the similar themes? Why? Besides more organized? Okay, very good. Because after you insert the keywords, what you need to do? You need to write ads. Remember? After insert keywords, you need to prepare the ads. First line, header. Second line, description 1. Third line, description 2. And put the display URL. It's the ad you will see on the search engine. So if today she doesn't group the keywords under the similar theme, then how can she write a more targeted ad? She can only write a very generic ad to talk about the product in general. She cannot focus too much on home decor because she's also selling flowers. Just imagine the ads, how the ads would look like. Sell everything at the cottage. That's how the ads would look like. But when she group everything in the similar themes, right, she can write a very, very targeted ads. So the first one, I only talk about flowers. Come to Little Cottage, buy roses, tulips, lilies, and jasmine from me. Then she can talk about occasions, important days in life, Valentine's, wedding, housewarming. Then when her ads is more targeted, she will help to, it will help her to increase the quality score. Then she can increase the ad rank. That is the whole intention. Ads to be very targeted. Increase the quality score for each keywords, because you put the keywords under the right theme, then when you increase your quality score, it will help you to improve your ad rank. So Vivian can decide now which country she wants to target: Malaysia, Singapore, or Thailand, or Indonesia. Then she has to decide, after she has decided the location, Then she has to decide the languages she wants to target. Whether it's English enough or she wants to target customers speak Malay or read in Malay or Chinese. After selecting her country and language, then she will focus on the categories. Category to adjust her bid, because she can use the bid adjustment to focus on the device which bring her most customer, the period which bring her most customer, and also the location which bring her most customer. So, device. Which device your customer will be using? Teenagers, definitely mobile phones. So you don't expect a senior citizen to use the mobile phone to access your site, because it's going to be quite hard for them to read everything. And if you are targeting office workers, you want to use desktop to reach them, because they will be spending time to work in the office, so they will be using less desktop or laptop most of the time. Then location, it's very easy to set the location, but we talk about the ad scheduling. To set a very effective ad scheduling, right, you need to understand your customers. You need to understand when will they make the purchase. So the purchase doesn't come every day. Whether the conversion as the sign up, you don't get every single day. Of course, it's easier to get conversion compared to asking people to pay money. So normally, an experienced advertiser, right, they will look at the historical performance and find out. So if I look at the hours of the day, from 7 a.m. to 12 p.m. or even 12 a.m. or even midnight, right? Which hour I will have the most customer to visit my website? As a campaign owner, as an advertiser, you want to find out. So this one relates back to your target audience. Based on your experience, when they will come to visit. Teenagers can be midnight because they do not need to sleep. Then office worker, lunchtime, working hours. Yeah, so maybe senior citizen, they tend to wake up earlier. And office worker, you also can target to them in the morning when they commute to work, especially those who take RRT and public transport. They will be using their mobile devices. So these are the things that you want to find out before you run the campaign. Besides the hour of the day, you look at whole week, Monday to Sunday, you will not have the same conversion every day. There's definitely one or two days, or maybe Monday to Wednesday, or Friday to Saturday, you will tend to get more customers or visitors to visit your site. Then, if you know which are the days, you can focus on the days of the week. And then, besides the hours of the day and day of the week, you also can look at the week of the month. Look at the whole month. We have 4 weeks. Will you get customer every single week? No, there are certain weeks you will tend to get more customer. So I'll give you an example. Job application. Job application normally will come in, let's say candidates apply for jobs, right? They will tend to apply for jobs in the second week or third week before they receive their salary. Then they find it very frustrated to work with this company, and I want to apply for job. So they will send more job application. Then maybe after they receive the salary, then they will stop. They feel that, okay, I get my paycheck, so I'll wait for a while, I'll see how first. That is some of the behavior. We need to dig out, find out more about our customers to understand how they behave, how they search for information, how they take actions. So besides the week of the month, you also can look at the month of the year. Some businesses, they only want to target customers during Christmas season. So month of the year, which month you will be focusing on? October, November, December. October, you want to start to be prepared for Christmas season. And for Chinese customer, you probably want to target them during Chinese New Year. The moment, the time, when they will tend to spend more money for Chinese New Year. So this is how you understand their preference and also behavior. So the big adjustment here, for Vivian, she wants to target Malaysia. and she wants to target customers who visit her site using the laptop and also the mobile device. And of course, she wants to set up the ad scheduling. And she also wants to target Malaysia using Bahasa, using Malay. And of course, the same targeting for the bid adjustment. And she also wants to target Singapore. But now, she don't want to use the desktop or laptop because she feels that Singapore, they have to commute to work using MRT. They will be with their phone most of the time. So it depends on the target customers you are targeting, you are getting. You should know some of their preferences. So campaign one, let's look at how can we adjust the bids. So when you go to the campaign and you click the setting, you will see all settings, location, ad schedule, and devices. So devices, it will show you computers, tablets with full browser, and mobile devices with full browser. Using Google AdWords will give you a very high level of flexibility. So you can choose which one you want to target. You want to go for computer, or you want to go for tablet with full browser, or for Vivian case, she probably wants to focus on mobile devices. Oh, sorry. So what you should do, if you want to focus on mobile devices, here the bid adjustment, you have to decide the percentage you want to increase. You want to increase by 50% or you want to increase by 90%. It's all up to you. It's all up to the campaign owner. So for Vivian, her case, any customers who are using the mobile devices to visit her site, she wants to adjust the bid by 50%. Why she wants to do that? Because she doesn't want to miss out the opportunity. She knows that 90% of her customer, let's say assume that 90% of the customer comes using mobile devices, why I want to miss out the opportunity. So when I manage to get this type of customer, I want to make sure that my bid is high enough so that I can compete with other competitors. It's not just you set the bids, your competitor, especially the big player in the market, right? They can set, you set $1, they can set $10. It means nothing to them. So you want to make sure they are not there grabbing your potential customer. So when Google detect this type of customer, is what Vivian's want. Help me, Google, help me to automate the bidding, adjust it more than 30% so that I compete with all the competitors, I outperform them, I grab the potential customers I want. That's the whole intention of bid adjustment. Increase by how many percent? So, some other example of different type of businesses. Just now we look at the Vivian's little cottage. She is selling the flowers, home decor items, and drinkware by occasion, by key occasion. Of course, you can have the Alex Music Emporium and look at how the Alex campaign is being set up. Guitar, electric, and the targeting, Alex said, Malaysia only, English language, and what is the bid adjustment he wants to set. He wants to improve not just mobile but also desktop and mobile placement. Yeah. Then another example, selling clothes. So how the campaign being structured, men's clothing, women's clothing, and all the ad groups below each campaign. Give you a bad example like I mentioned just now for the Vivian's little cottage example. So if you put all your keywords together, so what types of ads can you write? We sell lots of furniture and have really good deals. Do you think people will click? Not targeted, and it sounds, yeah, not specific, it sounds fake. It's like, you know, are you trying to call me? Are you trying to get me to visit to a scam site or asking for money? Then good example here, you will have the USEN campaign. You see the way they set up the campaign name. Then Leather Love Seat ad group, look at the ads, free delivery and great selection, because the campaign owner knows that by offering the free delivery can get customers to come to your site at least to take a look, rather than just ignoring your ads. Save 10% today. Who doesn't want discount? Who doesn't want promo? So will definitely help to increase the click-through rate. And the keywords suggested are very, very relevant, leather rather than other types of material. And the leather coaches, and also the ads and the keywords. Okay, my client center, we have to cover this one because you will have some questions asked by Google during the exam. So basically, my client center is heavily used by agency. Agency, they have multiple clients. Every client has their own Google AdWords account. So how can they manage? They use the My Client Center. So for the large advertiser, for agency, so that if I'm the agency account manager, I just need to do the single login. I do not need to log into every client's Google AdWords account using different login name and password, but I just use my Google login. Then when I log into the My Client Center, I will see the multiple account all part under one single access. Then I can run the reports to oversee the all the performance of all my clients. And I also can assign the different access. Let's say I'm the account manager of agency ABC, and I have different teams working for different clients. So client A account, I only want to grant access to my colleague 1, 2, and 3. So I can do that access by allowing them only see the client A's report. Then I have client B with their reports. So I only want to grant the access to the my team who is managing the account B clients campaign. So I grant the access to my team, who is probably the XYZ. So only them can see the client's report. But me as the account manager, I can see all the reports, and it will save my time because I do not need to remember the login details. I do not need to, grant the access and then delete the access, manage this multiple times. I just can do the single login, look at everything, all the performance, and then decide should I improve the performance or should I talk to my account manager on certain issues. So where can you access to the Google Client Center? So basically you can go to this URL, sign up for account. So this is the hierarchy for the MCC at, for example, mcc@agency.com. You will have the client account access with B2B at agency or B2C at agency. So you can set up the MCC account by grouping your clients into B2B or B2C, then grant the different access to different colleagues. And budget in MCC, you can have the share budget, you can have control over your client's budget. That is only for the MCC account. Benefits of MCC, let's recap. Single login, all accounts. Then you link to clients' account because clients, they want to keep their accounts. Not every client wants you to create a new account for them. If they already have the existing account, you just need to use their account to run the new campaign or improve their campaigns. Then of course, with the MCC account, you have the control over all the accounts owned by your clients. And you have the roll-up reporting, you can see the performance of all clients. This is the control over managed account budget using the manager defined spend. That's the share budget. Best practice, use campaign setting for targeting. Targeting by language, targeting by location. Organize your campaign and ad group into common themes. I think the Vivian's Little Cottage example show us how important to have your keywords group in common theme. Because you want to write a very targeted ads to increase the quality score for the keywords group under each theme, so that you can improve your ad rank, so that you can go for higher position with lower cost. Yeah. So create many tightly knit ad groups to ensure relevance between the keyword ad and landing page. To increase quality score, you still need to increase the click-through rate, optimize your landing page, have higher relevance on the ads copy you write, and utilize the enhanced campaign feature to increase or lower bids to particular devices. So like the bid adjustment we mentioned just now, if you know your customer well, you know when they will visit your site, you know which location they come from, either by radius or by zip code or by city or by region, then you will probably want to focus on the selected location, certain hours per day or certain week per month, or you can target them by device, whether they come to visit you using mobile device, desktop, laptop or tablet. Okay, we have some scenario questions here. Fun time. Okay. Donna sells t-shirts featuring vintage album covers. She wants people searching for unusual t-shirt to find her website, but she also thinks people interested in music might make a purchase. What campaign type would you recommend? Always look for the keywords. The keywords here is searching. Searching belongs to search network. What campaign type would you recommend?
See.
Yes, because she wants people who are on the search network using keywords to look for information. That one she cannot target them using display. She has to target them using search. Then she also wants people who are interested in music. How to get people who are interested in music? Yes, yes, that is the targeting available on display network. So what she needs is the campaign with the combined network. Search network with display select or features. So next one. What happens when a campaign consistently meets its average daily budget? Are you looking for the answer, missed opportunity? Not here.
Donkey.
Which one? C. Why C? Google will not change your budget on behalf of you. Google always respect you. If you decide to spend 50 ringgit a day, they will follow. If you decide to spend 1,000, they will also follow. There is no such thing as, you know, Google automatically adjusts your budget. No way.
Donkey.
Yep. Ads in that campaign will show less often than they could. Yeah, because they will stop running your ads. If you are using standard, then if you already... If let's say you are using the standard method, right, and if you have already spent all your budget, then they have no choice but to show your ads less often. So let's say your budget already spent in the morning, but you are using the standard method, so what they will do, because they promise you they should display your ad evenly throughout the day, so they will just show maybe like 50% or 30% in the morning, then save it for evening, then another how many percent to show your ad. So it's actually the same way as, you know, another way to tell you that you miss out the opportunity. One of your clients wants to know why a campaign went over the specified daily budget several days in a row. What would you explain to your client about how the AdWords system works? Sorry? B. Very fast. What What is the answer? D. B or D? Google will not simply adjust your budget or increase your budget without you changing your budget. They also will not ask for your approval using email. No, you are the one who decide how much you want to spend. Yeah. So the answer is actually D. It cannot be B. Yeah. If Google allows up to 20%, right, that means you have to spend more because they allow up to 20%. And why D? Because in certain days, right, you probably can get more customer visiting your site, and Google doesn't want you to miss the opportunity. And Google knows that you have not spent all your budget, but you have more opportunity, so they would increase your spend for 20% more, and then the specified budget, but overall performance, right, they will not increase your maximum budget, the budget you set the whole day. They will still try to reduce it back, just that when they detect the opportunity, they increase on behalf of you 20%, then after that they will lower down to make sure that your monthly budget will not exceed. What's the reason to use the search network with display select campaign type? Yes, you can use one budget to advertise on the search network and display network. So, your client gets more conversion from ads that appeal to people in Tokyo. What action should you take to try and increase the number of conversion for this client? Appeal to people in Tokyo. Is A. So because you know that you have more customer coming from Tokyo, so you just want to adjust a bit, especially when you know that your customers are from Tokyo, you want to make sure that you can compete with your competitor, other advertiser, to win the potential customers. Each campaign in your AdWords account should have a single is the keyword.
Business goal.
You can have multiple landing pages. If you have multiple campaigns, multiple ad groups, you can have multiple landing pages. Of course, you will have multiple ad groups. Let's say if you have different themes like Vivian's Little Cottage, how can you stick with one ad group? So not B, not C. Maximum. You cannot have a single maximum cost per click because you have so many keywords. Or are at the different cost per click because of the different competitor you are competing with. So there's only one thing, which is single goal, business goal for each campaign. Yeah. Your new client's AdWords account has one campaign with one ad group that contains a list of hundreds of keywords. Which best practice should you follow when reorganizing this client's keywords? So, your clients have the ad group that contains a list of hundreds of keywords. So you want to reorganize the keywords. B. Create new ad groups with related keywords grouped together. So when you have the similar question, right, always remember, look for the keywords in the answer where they have the related relevant. Similar, related, relevant, and group the keywords together. Your travel agency client is running a very targeted campaign to reach people who are visiting Paris on vacation and don't live in France. What would be an effective way to target these client customers? So, you want to target people who are visiting Paris but they are not in France. Create a campaign targeting Paris and language other than French, because customers from other countries, they will not set their user interface language as French, but you want to target people who are searching for Paris. A Malaysian can search for Paris using the keyword visit Paris from Malaysia. So that is the setting you want in order to target people who are visiting Paris but don't live in France. What strategies should Giorgio use to increase the number of relevant clicks from his search network campaign? Increase the number of relevant clicks. What should he do? Sorry? Very smart. Add new relevant keywords and remove keywords with low click-through rate. You cannot broaden your keyword because you probably will end up, you know, targeting the not relevant keywords. And increase bids for ads with the lowest average position and click-through rate, not as effective as adding new relevant keywords, because there must be reason why you are not achieving result, why certain keywords you have very low click-through rate. So you can, if you increase the bids for the low click-through rate keywords, right, you are actually not solving the problem. What you need is probably a better set of keywords, more relevant keywords to help you to improve the campaigns. An advertiser should group their campaigns by not B,
A.
Yeah, A type of product or service. That is the easiest way for you to structure your account. Look at the website. Let's say if you have multiple clients, go to visit their website and see how they arrange the categories, the pages, the subcategories. Your client's campaign is constantly meeting its average daily budget. What should you do to maximize your client's budget throughout all hours of the day? If you want to maximize your client's budget, of course you don't pause the campaign. Not B.
B.
B. Yeah, change the ad delivery method from accelerated to standard. Your ad can show to a user when your targeted language matches. How they detect your language? Is the? Yes. Google interface language setting. That one determines the language of your customers, used by your customers. Which client would you ever advise to use radius targeting? Radius targeting from how many miles? Yes, yes, the businesses with physical location or the businesses who wants to target customers from neighborhood. Tom wants to promote his windshield repair company's emergency service by reaching people right when they are searching for help. Which campaign type is a good fit? Keyword is searching.
Search network.
Yeah, search network only. Why not search network with display? Select. Yeah. Sorry? What's one benefit of creating multiple ad groups? Why you want multiple ad groups? Yes. That's the reason why you create multiple ad groups, because you want to make sure that you put all the keywords in the right themes or related themes. You sign 3 new clients, each with an existing AdWords account. What is the best way to manage this account?
Remember?
Wow! Awesome! When you want to link your client's account, the reason why you want to link is because you want to use their budget. So the clients, because the account owns by them, they will set up the account, use your billing use their billing information. So what you do now is just to link them up, you can continue to use their budget. That's the. For your single account, your own account, not the client's account, you cannot have. You only can choose one method. So you go for postpaid, then you go. If you want to change to prepaid, then you change. But you cannot at the same time having postpaid and prepaid. So if the client wants to,
they want the payment to,
yeah,
to be directly billed to their account, so that means to their own business account instead,
yeah,
of yours.
Yeah.
So they have to create a separate AdWords account to link to our.
No, no. When you are using the MCC, right, that means they still use the preferred billing method. Just that they grant the access for you to oversee their performance, to get their report, and also at the same time to grant people's access, to grant poor people access. So they are still getting the billing information sent to the set address, so it will not change the billing information. That's the reason many agencies, they don't want to create the accounts for their clients, because if you want to create the account for their clients, how you settle the bills? You use your credit card and claim back from clients, or you ask the client to create their accounts with their billing information all set up, then allow you to access the account. So if you want budget, you just spend from the client's account. Mimi wants to reach people searching for baked goods, but only wants her ads to show during the hours she opened for business. Which campaign type is a good fit? Keywords. What are the important keywords? Okay.
Remarkable.
During the hours. So,
remarkable.
You searching. Searching is also important keywords. Searching for baked goods, but only wants her ads to show during the hours she opened for business.
See.
So it's a search network. Only. Because from the question here, we don't mention about the different type of website or browsing different site. It's only searching. And then how can she do that? During the hours she opened for business, you can actually schedule your ads. If you are running Google campaign, you can decide. I only want to display my ads from morning 8 to 1 p.m. or from 5 p.m. to 11 p.m. All decided by you. In order to appeal to customers on mobile devices, it's important to. Yes, yes. Send user to a mobile friendly landing page, not the video based, not the avoid using ad extension, and also not the phone number. Mobile friendly page. Most of the website, they should have the responsive, mobile responsive design. If not, right, if your customers are viewing your site from the mobile devices and you don't have a mobile friendly landing page, you probably have to use the hand to zoom. Yeah. And it is actually a very bad experience for them, and they will not visit your site again. While teaching a new account manager how to build a search campaign, you tell her that she should group similar keywords together in an ad group because it will allow her to. Search campaign, group similar keywords together. Yes, because it will allow her to create ads that are relevant to keywords. I know I repeat many times, but I still need to repeat, because relevant ads will increase the quality score, and then to increase the quality score will help you to increase the ad rank. Julian wants to reach potential customer based on the type of device they are using, but he doesn't know how his campaign performs on different devices. How can Julian find meaningful data that will help him decide which devices to target? How can Julian find meaningful data? Meaningful data. Where can you find meaningful data? First, you need reports, right? Reports. Where to get meaningful? Let's say if you don't understand your customer at all, you do not know whether they come from your site using mobile devices or desktop, the first thing you want to do is to Look at the reports, look at the statistics. That is the first thing you should do. It's not to change any campaign or start any new campaign, but look at the existing performance so that you understand more about your customer. So, segment his campaign statistic table by device. So when you segment your campaign statistic, right, what you will be looking at will be the numbers for each device. Google AdWords will show you the performance from mobile only, the performance from desktop, and the performance from tablet. Desktop and tablets, and desktop and laptop, and the performance from tablets. Cliff just started working with a client who has a very disorganized AdWords account. What's an effective way for him to begin restructuring his client's account? So the answer is B. Why B? Because you have to restructure the account. Remember the hierarchy? We start with account, then campaign, then ad group. Keyword is at the ad group level. But now if you need to restructure the account, the first thing you need to do is to look at the campaign. Then after you fix the campaign, you look at the ad group and also the keywords and ads. Now it's so okay. Biddings, just give me a little bit more time. We try to cover this one. Okay. Bidding strategy. It depends on your campaign's goal, whether you want to get clicks, impressions, or conversions. So if you want to get clicks, Google has one type of bidding strategy for customers who are just looking for clicks, and it's very effective. It's called the cost per click bidding. Yeah, CPC bidding, cost per click bidding. So you only pay when someone clicks your ad. So if only they only see your ads, they don't click, right, you don't pay. And that's for customers who are looking for number of clicks, more clicks, increase the clicks, and bring more people to their site. So under the CPC bidding, there are three different types of strategy. So you have manual, you have automatic, and you have enhanced CPC bid adjustment. The second one, customers just want to generate awareness. So they don't care whether you click their ads or you don't. They just want to make sure that you see their ads. For this type of customers, they can go for impression. It's called CPM bidding. CPM stands for cost per thousand impressions. So for this bidding, it's suitable for customers who are looking for brand awareness. They just want to get the message in front of the customers. And the next one, for customers, especially the e-commerce owners, e-commerce advertiser, they want to get conversion, they want to get purchase, they want to get revenue. So for this type of customer, they can go for conversions, CPA bidding. CPA stands for cost per acquisition. So it's the bidding where Google AdWords helps you to measure the cost per conversion. You will know how much it will cost for you to get one purchase, or how much it will cost for you to get one sign up. Manual versus automatic bidding. Manual bidding. Why some advertiser they go for manual bidding, some advertiser they go for automatic bidding? What is manual bidding? Manual means that if today you set your bids to 1 ringgit, Google will not adjust for you. It will remain 1 ringgit forever until you log into your account and you adjust it by yourself. And why customers wants to go for manual bidding and why some customers they don't want to? So for manual bidding, it gives you the control because you can decide how much you want to increase. You don't want to pass the control to Google and let them decide for you. But the biggest disadvantage for the manual bidding will be the efficiency. Just imagine the number of the keywords you have. Let's say you have 100 keywords, which means that you need to set the bid for each keyword and then adjust the bid manually for each keyword. Not everyone can do that. So, there is another type of bidding for those who cannot cope with manual bidding, who doesn't want to have the manual bidding, they can go for automatic bidding. Automatic bidding means that if today you set 1 ringgit for your keyword, Google will help you to increase your bids. If Google sends that you have more competitors compete for this keyword, because you let Google do the control, you believe in Google intelligence to help you to increase the bids and to be able to compete with the other advertisers. If you are using automatic bidding, you definitely have less control because you cannot decide how much you want to increase. You will let Google to decide. Maybe Google would increase from 1 ringgit to 1 ringgit 50 cent, or maybe they will increase more. But it will save you a lot of time because most of us, we will have multiple keywords, so we do not need to manually take care of all the keywords. We let Google do the job. They will not exceed the budget. The automatic bidding, you just apply the bidding strategy, but you will not exceed the budget for sure. Then enhanced CPC, this one I will skip first because it's I cannot click the link here, so I'll skip first. We can watch the video tomorrow, but I want to tell you another type of bidding. So just now we cover the manual bidding, automatic bidding. We have one more, enhanced CPC. So what is enhanced CPC? Enhanced CPC means that if Google detects that you have more opportunity, Google wants to help you to increase the bids to more, not more than 30%. They will not increase your bids more than 30%. But you allow them when they detect that you have more opportunities. So conversion optimizer is for the CPA bidding. So for CPA bidding, cost per acquisition bidding, if you want to apply that bidding strategy, you need to set up the conversion optimizer. If not, you have to use the manual bidding or the automatic bidding or the enhanced CPC bidding. So conversion optimizer will look at your historical data and look at which area actually help you, which area, which location, or which device, or which website actually help you to get more conversions. Then they will try to allocate more spend to focus on that category. That is how smart the conversion optimizer is. So based on your historical data, if they notice that most of your customers who make the purchase on your site actually come from a beauty site, then they will put your budget, they will get your budget, try to allocate more budget and spend on the customer coming from beauty site, or spend on the beauty site, other beauty site. But they have to look at your historical performance first, and that's the conversion optimizer. So let's look at the overall bidding strategy, bidding types. You have the manual CPC bidding, you have to adjust the bid by yourself. You have the automatic CPC bidding, you have the enhanced CPC bidding, and you have the conversion optimizer bidding, which is the CPA cost per acquisition bidding, and you also have the flexible bidding and viewable CPM bidding. So I just focus on this one first. Flexible bidding basically is a bidding strategy offered by Google AdWords, where you can set different types of bidding based on campaign, ad groups, or keyword. For example, if you feel that, or from data, it shows that buy smartphone keywords will get you higher conversion. So you can use flexible bidding to adjust the bid for that particular keyword. Or you feel that, or you see the result, it proves that you can get higher conversion from campaign 1 or ad group 2. Then you can just focus on that ad group, adjust the bid, and help you to generate more conversion. And the next one will be the viewable CPM bidding. That is for a user who spend 1 second and more on your ads. Why they want to set 1 second and more? Because they want to make sure that it's not the refresh. Sometimes the customer, when they look at your ads, right? Sometimes they click here and click there. They don't even pay enough attention on your display ad. So Google introduced the viewable CPM bidding. Make sure that they do spend at least 1 second or more than that to look at your display ads. So Google's flexible bidding strategy, we do not need to focus on all, but basically I just want to touch on the target search page location and the target ROAS, target search page location. Why we want to use that bid strategy? Because we want to create our ad visibility. Target search page location means that I want to push my ads to the position above the search engine result. I don't want it to be at the right hand side. I just want to go to the top of the search result at the 1, 2, 3 position before the search result. And target ROAS, basically the advertiser who use the bid strategy of target ROAS, they want return on spend. So for them, right, they need to generate enough revenue to cover the cost of the bids. Then bid adjustment compatibility. Some of the where can you manage the bid adjustment, whether it's at the ad group level or at the campaign level, and how the bid adjustment will apply to the strategy you have selected. So for the conversion optimizer bidding, right, as we seen on the some of the previous slide, you can increase the percentage of mobile devices, the bid adjustment for mobile devices, if you know that your customers will browse your site using mobile devices. But what if you minus 100%? It means that you are not targeting anyone using mobile devices. You also can do that. You can increase the bids by setting the percentage, but at the same time, you can block visitors from certain device or certain location or certain period of time. Yeah. So that is the campaign level bid modifier by location, devices, and ad schedule. And of course, you have the ad group level bid modifier. It means that if you want to set the bid adjustment for location, device, and ad schedule, you can only do it at campaign level. But for device, you can do it at the ad group level. So if you have the ad group of flowers, drinkware, home decor, then you can adjust and set it according to the device you want. But for locations and ad schedule, you cannot target on changing the bid for the flower, drinkware, and also all the ad groups, because it can only be done at the campaign level. Okay, let's quickly go through this one, then you all can go back. So, which statistic indicates how often a click has led to a conversion? Conversion rate. It's not the cost per conversion, it's how many people get converted after visiting your site. When receiving your client's search network campaign, you notice that the ads in one of the ad group have a low average position. Which flexible bid strategy should you use to help improve the position of this ad? Keyword, low average position. Target search page location. Because target search page location basically is to help you to increase the ad visibility. You want to make sure that your ads position get higher. So when you look at the keyword average position, you choose this one. And this question here, they don't mention about the revenue generator, so you shouldn't choose C or the enhanced cost per click. Which bidding strategy should Sarah use if her goal is to get more people to call her local catering business? Local catering business.
Cost per click.
Call her local catering business. So how Google charges advertiser based on the call they receive, actually it's same as the click. You pay for the call, it's similar to the money you pay for the click. When setting up a search network campaign for a client, you want to maximize the number of clicks her ads can get. Which bidding strategy should you use to achieve this goal? Maximize the number of clicks her ads can get. automatic cost per click. Yeah. Number of clicks. So you don't go for manual because you need to adjust the bid manually one by one. So you go for the automatic one. Which is the best bidding option for an advertiser who wants to drive more clicks from mobile devices? Drive more clicks from mobile devices. Yes, mobile bid adjustment. We adjust the bid when we have customer coming to our site using mobile devices. How do cost per click ads compete with cost per thousand impression ads on the Google Display Network? Okay, this one is a tough question. Let me explain. Okay, so you have two advertisers competing with each other. So one using cost per click, another one using cost per impression. Cost per click means that the advertiser only pay if someone clicks his ads. Then cost per impression means that you pay when people see your ads. Cost per thousand impression, as long as people see your ads, you are paying. So when you have advertiser both using different bidding strategy and compete with each other, right? What Google will do is to convert the CPC to CPM. They call it eCPM. So remember, when you have two advertisers competing with each other using different bidding strategy, the CPC will be converted to CPM. We call it eCPM. So the answer is CPC bids are effectively converted to CPM bids. What does converted clicks measure? So if you go to the Google report, you will see the words converted clicks. You will see the conversion. You also will see the metrics called converted clicks. Basically, the converted clicks will show you the total number of clicks that give you the conversion. So if let's say you have a customer make a purchase on your site, the customer cannot be just visiting your site one time and immediately make the purchase. The customer probably has to visit your site 5 times, contribute 5 clicks, then only can make the purchase. So converted clicks refer to the total number of clicks the customer contribute to your app and then come to your site and then convert. An advertiser looking to drive conversion is using manual cost per click bidding. Which factors should be most important for this advertiser when keyword bids are decided? So we are looking at manual cost per click.
Donkey.
Who said A? Yeah?
Donkey.
No, it's actually A.
Oh.
Yeah. It's not the quality of the quality score of the keyword, because we are talking about the cost per click, the cost of the keyword. It's not about, you know, improving your ad position with lower cost. It's not this. So quality keywords cannot influence the manual cost per click. And it's also not the cost of the bid, but it's actually the profit derived from a paid click. Because when the advertiser decides the manual cost per click, right, he has to remember he must cover the cost he paid for the click. He must generate more revenue so that he can decide, okay, I want to set the manual bidding of 10 ringgit. But if I can get the customer go to my site, they make a purchase, I can earn 50 ringgit. He must decide, because he is the person who decides the bids, not Google. If Google decides the bid, Google will look at the historical data and suggest a bid to you. But when a person, when an advertiser, they decide a bid, they are not using historical data, they are making the decision based on their own. So they have to be careful, make sure that they have generated enough revenue to cover the cost of the click. Conversion Optimizer can help drive conversions by using your conversion history and CPA goals to show the optimal ad when a conversion is more likely. Remember how Conversion Optimizer works? They will look at the area, the location, or the website which are more likely to give you the conversions and focus on the yeah, the selected area. Yeah.
Okay,
that's all for today. Tomorrow we will cover the second part. Tomorrow, please be punctual. We will start at 5:30 sharp. We will try to finish tomorrow's session so that we have some time for discussions before your exam on Wednesday. Okay, have a good rest and I'll see you tomorrow.
Guys, the lecturers are going to be over here if you want to ask any questions, if you're